Okay, it's now time for our last talk of the day. It's going to be given by Sheila Menon. Sheila is the principal of the London College of Clinical Hypnosis in Asia and Australia. She has over 20 years of experience as a clinical hypnotherapist and is a fellow of the British Association of Medical Hypnosis and the British Society of Clinical Hypnosis. She is also a past president of the Malaysian Society of Clinical Hypnosis. Being a hands-on principal, Sheila lectures in London and Asia and is one of the directors of the LSCCH Therapy Centre at Pantai Hospital in Kuala Lumpur. She is also the international editor for the European Journal of Clinical Hypnosis and a regular contributor on BFM Radio and to Shape magazine. Sheila is going to give the closing address, after which there will be a group photograph and several breakout rooms for you to choose from. And I'll give more information about that after this talk. But now over to Sheila. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Julian, am I coming across all right?
Yeah, you're coming across really fine, Sheila. Go ahead.
Thank you very much. Hello, everyone. It's such a pleasure to be here with you. I'm just trying to get myself back in. I've sort of drifted off to that really nice favorite place. Thank you very much, Dr. Thamer. So thank you very much for joining us from across all those different time zones. I know some of you got up a little earlier than usual, especially from the UK and Europe and Scotland. And I know our Australian colleagues have delayed bedtime to stay here. So thank you so much for that. And here in Asia, I think many of us are going to have some very late suppers. And I'd just like to say thank you to the two people who joined us across from the Americas. With your presence, you made it a truly international event. We could not and would not have had such an inspiring conference without all of you being here today. So thank you. The pandemic and the various lockdowns have created havoc for so many people, but they've also created opportunities for people to come together and to share ideas. Of course, we know that across the globe, there's been some fairly crass behavior, but there's also been shows of unbelievable kindness, of mutual support and generosity, not just from the helping professionals, but by people throughout communities. In this conference, mental health care professionals, medical doctors and clinical hypnotherapists have worked together. And the result has been a spectacular sharing experience with the opportunity to explore new ideas and to learn different ways of working from each other that will enhance our practice and certainly help our clients and patients. Of course, everyone attending today understands the importance and the value of mental health care. And finally, it seems that the world is also listening to us. It may have taken a pandemic, but governments around the globe are recognizing the need to scale up quality mental health care services at all levels. And importantly, there have been many commitments for action following the World Health Organization Assembly in May of this year. So this conference is not just about sharing new ways of helping our clients, it's also about networking and learning from each other. And this space has been made particularly special because it's brought therapists from five international professional societies around the globe closer together. In fact, one could almost say it's been a conference of presidents because many of the speakers are presidents of their own respective societies. It's been an amazing show of solidarity amongst the professions. I would like to thank the British Society of Clinical Hypnosis for extending their usual warm and generous support, and to say a particular thank you to Mr. Tom Connolly, the secretary, who's been our MC this weekend. We're delighted to be working again with the Malaysian Mental Health Association. This association was established in 1967 to promote the mental well-being of in Malaysia through advocacy, through education, through training and research. And it's been a double honor because we've had both the president, Dr. Andrew Mohan Raj, and the past vice president, Dato Tanya Kwa, to speak at this conference. Now, their support for clinical hypnotherapy stretches all the way back to the very first conference we organized in Malaysia in 2015. So thank you for your continued collegiality, and we're looking forward to working together in future initiatives. Of course, conferences provide the opportunity to make new friends, and the Australian Hypnotherapists Association is the largest national professional society for clinical hypnotherapy in Australia. It dates back to 1949, and it has members throughout Australia and New Zealand. And it's been a pleasure to get to know the committee and to plan not just this conference, but future events and projects right into 2022. I know it's extremely late in Victoria, so I'd like to send a special thank you to the President, Ms. Danielle Akins, for speaking to us at our conference yesterday. You know, there's been so much goodwill shared during this conference that it would take too long to thank everyone. But a special thank you should go to the Malaysian Society of Clinical Hypnosis, to Crown House, to the Asia Pacific Society of Clinical Communications and Hypnosis, the National and International Council of Psychotherapists, the Portuguese Association of Clinical Hypnosis, the Australian Society of Clinical Hypnotherapists, Hypnosis Plus, Peter Mabbott, of course, the President of the British Society of Clinical Hypnosis, and our moderator, Dr. Anna Purney. And of course, to the 11 international and expert speakers who've shared so much and so openly over the last 2 days. And of course, there must be a very special thank you to all of you who've added your voice to the collective sharing, who've communicated through the chats and the question time, who've reached out and networked with each other, and really together made this a truly memorable event. Now, we've come through some of the darkest emotional times in living history, in living memory, and our conference theme, we've come through some of the darkest emotional times in living memory. And our conference theme is living and thriving in the new normal. And it's our commitment to look forward with optimism. One of the most positive experiences that's come from these sad times has been the ability to meet and to share so easily with so many people through the wonders of technology. And on that note, I'd like to say thank you to the organizing committee, the LSCCH and the LSCCH Asia secretariats, and in particular, Mr. Julian Pereira and Mr. Steve Winston for working so well behind the scenes and providing such effortless technical support, to Dr. Asha for looking after our delegates, and to Ms. Raji Grant and Ms. Sylvia Pereira and Ms. Sun Lee for all their work that made this weekend such a success. You guys have done such an amazing job and no doubt deserve a deep and long, and possibly several days and several nights of deep, long sleep. So as we look forward into 2022, it's time to ask those important questions about what's next. You know, we're certainly looking forward to getting to know each other much better. And one of the highlights of international sharing has been the opportunity to learn from diverse cultures and to discover that whilst our methods of working may vary, our commitment to our clients and our profession does not. The first conference in June of this year launched the Virtual Therapy Centre in the UK and Malaysia and Singapore. In this November conference, five different mental health care societies have created a shared space for future collaboration. I cannot help but look forward to the next conference in 2022. And of course, there have been lessons to learn. The first is to recognize that different time zones are here, and we have to make a commitment to reschedule and start the times a little earlier so our Australian colleagues can get to bed before 10 p.m. And we have shortened the name of the conference. We've returned to our original theme and selected the name, which is now the Your Mind Matters Conference. And we very much hope to see all of you at the next conference on the 4th and 5th of June in 2022. So that's a little reminder to just mark it in your calendars. And finally, we continue to network and grow. And we're looking forward to sharing the organizing of the next conference with our colleagues in the different regions. It is hard work, but we promise you that it's also extremely rewarding. And I'd like to leave you with the thought that when people of similar intention gather, change can, and very often, does take place. So thank you all for being part of this amazing weekend, and I hope to see you next time.